welcome back to the channel. And it's been a long time since I've made a new video post that's kind of a tutorial. And although I don't consider myself an expert in any regard, there is something that's come up over the last several months as people have taken a look at my work, maybe on Etsy or things that I've shared online. And that's that transition between going from stippling being strictly black and white, using black ink on white paper, into a colored medium and the papers that I might use or something else. About a year and a half ago, I did an octopus in color where I used a variety of different colors. I wanted to show you how I did that, but using maybe a little bit more of a simple kind of an example, a frog that I did as well, and kind of walk you through that process. It's not really complex. It's not much more than regular dots like we took a look at with the rhinoceros that we did previously, but this time we're going to be using colors. A couple points along that line, some things that I've kind of figured out as I've gone through. The importance of the pens that you do choose. Usually when I'm doing black and white, I just use the Pigma Sakura Micron pens, and I use a variety of nibs on those. I might use the 0.005 or all the way up to 0.08, which gives me a much larger diameter. When I use the color, I didn't use different diameter nibs, but I did use different pens. The pens that I usually use, the Pigma Microns, this is definitely a pen that you can use. I find it to be awesome. It's got great color fastness. That means that it'll last a long time. It's archival quality and it's permanent. So it's fantastic. I recommend these pens to everyone. The other thing that's really nice about them is they dry pretty quickly. So once you put them to paper, the dots start drying immediately. The downside to them is that the colors they can come in tend to be a little more limited. It's a nice permanent line, they make great marks, but you're limited to the colors that they have, and they tend to be a little bit darker in color. And so using them can be a little tricky and you won't have quite as much variance. I used them for one that I just used a couple different colors, and that was a picture of an orangutan that I did years ago. And so that just used a few different colors, so it was nice for me because they were all kind of darker colors. The other kind of pen that I'd like to kind of walk you through is the Stabilo orange pens, I guess you can say. These come in a variety of colors and they're really awesome. These bright colors that you can use. And I think those are the ones that I've used primarily for this project that I did with the frog, because I was able to get some colors that I wouldn't have been able to get with just using the Pigma Sakura. So the negative, the downside to these pens is they are a water-based pen. Now, that means you can use them for different things like a watercolor. You can add water to it and blend the colors up. But when we're talking about using them for stippling, the fact that they're water-based, they don't dry very rapidly. When you go to layer your colors, you need to make sure that the layers are dry. What ends up happening, if you don't layer your colors, if you just put them one on top of the other, they tend to get muddy. They tend to blend together. So if you're using these pens, take a little bit of time to let it dry. Use a hairdryer if you have to. Use one color at a time before you switch to another. And you might actually see that in the video that I have when I start doing the eye. I didn't wait quite long enough and the orange and the red kind of muddy up together. The last kind of pen that I wanted to share with you is the Staedtler Tri Plus Fine Liner, and the reason I used this pen is because they had this really nice blue color that I couldn't get elsewhere. It's also nice because it doesn't roll around very much. It's got a kind of a triangular grip, so it was really nice and stable for me. And these are kind of in between. I believe they are water-based, I'm not positive, but it was kind of a difference halfway in between price between the Stabilos and the Pigmas. So that's the pen that I used. To be able to do these, I did them on the exact same paper that I did previously. On all my stippling projects, I use the Canson bristle board. Usually use smooth finish over a vellum finish, and that actually holds the ink really nicely. So those are the tools that I use. I keep it real simple. So as with a lot of my work, I start with either a sketch that I'll do freehand or I'll do a tracing. Because when you are drawing or you're doing this stippling, you have to think of it kind of halfway in between of a watercolor and a stippling project. Adding layers is going to be key. So you'll see here I start with the lighter colors, and then on top of the lighter colors, I'll add the darker colors, the darker reds and the oranges on top of the yellows. You'll see that I started with a bold area. I started in the top left-hand corner, which I use an awful lot. I started with that eye because drawing right-handed and going from left to right prevents smudging, especially with this where the ink takes a little bit longer to dry. The water-based ink takes a little longer to dry. It helps me to be able to go from left to right, so I'm not overlapping that. If you're left-handed, obviously it might be helpful for you to go in reverse. You won't get a perfect color every time. Even though I've got a wide variety of colors with the Stabilo, I have to combine things to make the colors just right. The greens aren't gonna be perfect and the blues won't be perfect, but when you start figuring out how it goes from one color to another, it's really helpful. Also, this picture looks really good when you back out, and that's exactly what stippling is all about. To make an effective stippling project, it really is helpful to look at it from far away. The beauty of stippling is that the closer you get, the more abstract the work actually is, so that when you're really close into it, it just is a bunch of dots all put together. When you back out and you go far away from it, then you've got your completed image. Once again, I'm not an expert at this. I'm a learner just like all of you. So if you have any questions, feel free to leave them below, or if you've got advice for other people, I'd love to be able to see that. Leave those in the comments. Subscribe to see more, and I really hope to see you in the future. Have a fantastic day.